Welcome to Creative DIY with Momdas for two easy harvest and Thanksgiving themed decor DIYs. For the first DIY, I'm going to make a Mr. and Mrs. Scarecrow. So I'm taking normal jam jars, bell jar or mason jars. These are nice and clean. Washed them, took the labels off and everything, and it's ready for crafting. Now one can paint them in the color of their choice, but I'm just going to fill them up with grains or pulses because I want to make it special for harvest or Thanksgiving. So this way I get color on my jars, and yet I don't have to use paint, and these are great representatives for harvest and Thanksgiving. And my food doesn't get spoiled. I don't at all like wasting food. Okay, so starting with the first one, so the coarse grain, I'll reserve it for the Mr. Scarecrow. Now for the Lady Scarecrow, I took a crushed piece of fabric. I wanted it nice and crushed. I place it on top of the lid, and using just an elastic band, I'm just going to secure it here and then trim it off so that it becomes like a hat kind of a thing. Trim off the extra and it's like this. Then I took some straw or hay, and I'm just going to make some hair strands for her. Just a little bunches like this, loose strands. And these I'm going to, you know, fix it underneath. The hat and hold it with the elastic bands. I'm just tucking it under the elastic band, and so I have some hair strands, loose hair strands on either side, not much. Next I took this brown paper, a ribbon kind of thing, and I'm going to glue it on the top like this. So here I have the head portion of my Lady Scarecrow, and I just took a sunflower, artificial one, and I'm going to glue it on top like this. So for the time being, this one so far. For the Mr. Scarecrow, I just added the brown ribbon band on top of the lid to hide the lid. And for his hair, I'm going to use some bunch of this, just put them into a little, you know, bunch kind of thing, and glue it. So just making a little bunch, and this something I'm just going to glue on top of the lid to hide the lid. Next, for a little bow for Mr. Scarecrow, I took this fabric and I folded it just to put the raw edges in, otherwise you can stitch them. Basically, I want to make a bow, so a bow like this. Then I took a small strip of yellow ribbon and I'm going to just place it in the center to finish my bow and glue it in place. And then I shall just, you know, glue the bow on top like this. So this will do the main structure of my Mr. Scarecrow. So far, Mr. and Mrs. Scarecrow look like this. And now for the faces. So I took a piece of orange fabric and I'm going to cut a nose shape. For that, I'm just making a triangle kind of thing here. Two such pieces, and I'm going to glue them right like this. Now I'm going to use some buttons, and I just added some glue at the back of them, and I'm using them to make the eyes of my scarecrow couple. Then I took a marker pen, a permanent marker or a glass marker, and I'm using it to make some stitch lines and to finish up my scarecrow couple. Now once the nose is done, I can do some. Today I'm participating in the fourth Friday challenge that is hosted monthly by Lisa from Our Grey House and Sarah from GGP DIY. So I'll be putting links to both Lisa and Sarah's channels. I'll take a playlist for more inspirations. Here is my Mrs. and Mr. Scarecrow, the Scarecrow couple. They're great for the harvest season, they're great for the Thanksgiving decor. They can be put on a tear tray or a Thanksgiving vignette. And I think they look really adorable, very cute. And I like to see the pulses showing through. It is representative of a good harvest. This is beautiful. You can even add corns or anything that you please, or just paint it if you like to. I really like them, they're so cute and adorable. For the second DIY, I'm going to make a cute little turkey shaped container to hold some goodies. So I needed a small container, so a small cup or a saucer or anything like that will do. So I have one such thing. Then I took an artificial flower and sunflower especially, and I'm going to glue my sunflower at the back of my container such that the petals, they just flare up like the feathers of the turkey. So either I'll cut the bottom petals or just fold them backwards like this and just glue it there. Now before that, let me make the face of my turkey. So I'm using two googly eyes. Now these are googly eyes, the inside eyes jiggle, and I'm just going to glue them on to my container to make the eyes. So once I have the eyes in place, I took two little fabrics in dark orange and yellow, and I'm going to fashion out beak out of it. Something like this. This is too big, so I need to make smaller beaks. So basically fashion out the face out of this. Now once the face is done, I added some glue at the back side of my container, and I'm just going to glue it with the flower. And here is the turkey container ready to hold some goodies for Thanksgiving. I hope you liked my two decor DIYs, which are useful at the same time and look beautiful and fit perfectly for the harvest season, for the Thanksgiving time. I hope you will make them too. Do let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this video, please give this a thumbs up and share this video. And if you're new here and love to DIY within budget, please consider subscribing. Thank you so much everybody for your time and appreciation. I'll see you soon.